Hi guys, so today we're going to make spaghetti and meatballs. So I'm gonna show you how I do it. I don't know if everybody does in the same way or no, but this is Gracie's way. So I'm gonna show you what I need, ingredients that I need, and how it's going to be made, okay? So first, you're gonna need some onions, tomato, pepper. And you need to have some ground beef, and we're going to do the mix for the meat, and we are also going to make what we need for the sauce. Okay, so I'm gonna show you how everything is gonna go, and I will keep telling you everything that goes into this dish. Okay, now like I told you before, this is Gracie's way. I hope you like it, and let's continue with this. Okay, what we're going to do right now is that we're going to fill it up because we need to cook the noodles. So let's fill this up, and we're going to add a little bit of salt and a little bit of oil, half a spoon of salt, and we're going to put a little bit of oil. I have a little bit in this container. And this is going to the stove, so it can start to boil, okay? So let's put it here. So while this is in the stove, we're going to start. For the sauce, we're going to use, actually, let's start with the mix for the meat. So, you know, everything can start having some flavor and everything there. So you need to have a container, okay? And in this container, you're going to put the meat. You're going to use ground beef. If you want, you can mix pork with beef, or you can use either or, whatever you like or you prefer, it's okay. So now, we're going to put the ground beef in this container. And to do the mix, we're going to use a little bit of onion. Now, if you have white onion, or you have red onion, or if you wanna mix them up, it's okay. So what I'm gonna do right now, as you can see, we're going to use a little bit of white onions, okay? And red ones, because I have this leftover, so I'm gonna use it now. So I'm gonna cut them off, or chop them, and then you turn this around, and you try to make it smaller, the little squares, okay? Be careful with your fingers. Make sure you have your fingers. I don't want to cut yourself. So this white onion is going to be mixed in the meat, and whatever is left over is going to be for the sauce. Okay, I'm chopping right now everything. Now, Chocito loves spaghetti and meatballs, and he asked me if I can make some today. So I told him that yeah, we have all the ingredients. He loves it, so I'm gonna make some today. Chocito's birthday was last Saturday, and I made tacos for him too. So when he asked me to do something that he loves, I try to make it. And it's not all the time that we prepare this type of dishes, because we kind of like want to leave it for special occasions. But this is a cool dish. Okay, so now this onion is going to be a little bit of this one is coming, and it's going to be mixed here with the beef. Okay, so let me put you guys a little bit more to the back so you can see, and we're going to mix it. As you can see, they are a little squares. Now, make sure that your meat is open it up like this. Okay? So, you put the onions. Look, if you want, you can even chop a little bit more. Look, you can make it even smaller if you want. All depends how you like it, okay? Estamos haciendo espagueti en meatballs o albóndigas con fideos. Y en este momento estoy cortando la cebolla. Estoy utilizando cebolla blanca para mezclarlo con la carne molida. Puede ser de res o puede ser de cerdo, o pueden mezclar diferentes carnes si ustedes quieren. Eso ya es opcional. En este momento estoy usando carne molida de res. Y como tenía este pedacito de cebolla blanca, la voy a mezclar con la carne y el resto la voy a dejar para la salsa. Para lo que voy a preparar de sauce, voy a utilizar cebolla roja o colorada, como le decimos acá. La vamos a cortar. Okay. So we're going to start cutting the onions. In this case, I'm going to use red onions. If you want, you can mix white and red, that's okay, it doesn't matter. I like the flavor, so it's good. Now, if you don't have white onions, you can use red ones, it's okay. If you don't have red ones, you can use white ones, that's fine. Right now, because I have a little leftover, I decide to use that little piece of white onions and complete the rest with the red one. Entonces, en este momento estoy cortando la cebolla colorada, y como tenía un pedacito de cebolla blanca, cebolla perla, perdón, aquí nosotros le llamamos cebolla perla. La cebolla blanca es otro tipo de cebolla, es lo que en Estados Unidos se le llama scallions. Okay, and these ones se llama cebolla perla. That's the white onions, okay? So, ahorita estamos cortando, igual lo van a hacer como cuadraditos. Yo decidí mezclar esta cebollita blanca porque era un poquito que me quedó, y está bien, no pasa nada. Si no tienen cebolla blanca, pueden utilizar roja en todo, o si no tienen cebolla roja, pueden utilizar cebolla blanca en todo, no importa. Todo depende de lo que ustedes quieran hacer. Y si les gusta, las pueden mezclar, no hay ningún problema tampoco. No va a salir mal. Ok, so now, this one is going to the pan that I'm going to use to make the sauce. Ok, I'm going to show you guys. Let me chop everything first. And until I continue chopping everything, let me wash my hands. So I can add it up some garlic and also a little bit of salt for the meat and one egg, okay? So let me get the egg, the salt, and the garlic, okay? So one second, guys. Now we use garlic mixed with onions, and we make a little aliño, nosotros le llamamos aliño. Is garlic mixed with one onion and a little bit of water, and that's it. That's something that if you like, you can actually make yourself. If not, you can buy it already from the store. They already sell it, made it and everything. I think it's good. It's a different option too. If you want, you can use this. If not, you can also use any type of seasoning. We have seasoning also, but right now I'm gonna use the garlic one. And a little bit of pepper too. Okay, so I'm gonna put a spoon of this garlic, as you can see. One and two, maybe one more. Okay. Oh, and I'm gonna use the same one for the onions. So I'm gonna put it up right now for the sauce. When is more garlic than water, then I just add one spoon because it's a little bit more thicker. Okay, so we have this, we close it. Oh, and make sure if you have something like this, make sure that it's actually in a container with a sealer and something that you can actually keep it in the fridge without making the whole fridge smell weird. Okay, so let's continue. You're going to see here, and we're going to put a little bit of pepper. Okay. One egg. Now, make sure that the egg is okay, because sometimes, you know, I don't know, something happened and maybe the egg is not right or something happened with the egg. So make sure that before you mix it with the meat, you check that the egg is okay by opening it up and see. The egg is fine, so I'm gonna mix it up with the meat, because once I didn't do that and I make another dish and the egg was bad for some reason. Something happened with that egg and it ruined the whole thing. So after that happens to me, I practically try to always put on the side. So now you're going to sprinkle a little bit of salt. Okay. And you're going to use your hands, okay, to actually mix this up, okay? So you're going to mix it. So here we have, let me add a little bit more salt. Okay. And you're going to mix this up. Now, some people use sometimes different other things like celery, sometimes they use breadcrumbs, sometimes they use tomatoes and they mix different stuff in here. In my case, I like to mix just the onions with the garlic, a little bit of salt and the egg, that's it. Because everything else is going to be in the sauce. But if you want to mix everything, it's optional, you can do that if you want, but obviously you have to make the sauce too. So, ahorita estamos mezclando la carne, la mezclé solamente con la cebolla perla, puse un poquito de sal, un poquito de pimienta y ajito que tenía hecho o aliño, lo mezclé y en este momento voy a dejar que esto se siga sazonando aquí, a un costadito. Mientras tanto me voy a lavar las manos, I'm gonna wash my hands, y voy a continuar chopping everything that I need for the sauce. Okay? So let me put this on the side, put it over here, and I'm gonna show you what it's going to be for the sauce. Okay? Let's continue. Now I have two tomatoes. Okay, you can use more than two if you want, you can use four, but I'm gonna use a little bit of tomato paste to make the sauce thick, and I also am gonna use a little bit of tomato sauce so it will be enough tomato there. Okay, so what I'm gonna do right now is that I'm gonna turn the stove on so the onions can start mixing it and they can start cooking. Okay, I'm peeling the tomato. Some people like to have the skin of the tomato in. I prefer not to, because sometimes the skin can get a little messy, a little plasticky, and I don't like that. So I prefer to peel the tomatoes. So that's what I'm gonna do. Okay. Entonces vamos a pelar los tomates. Yo prefiero pelarlos porque no me gusta, a veces la piel del tomate se hace como si fuera un plastiquito ahí extraño y eso no me agrada, por eso yo pelo los tomates. Pueden usar más de dos tomates si quieren. Yo voy a usar dos tomates porque voy a también utilizar pasta de tomate y voy a utilizar la salsa que venden para hacer espaguetis. También, no salsa de tomate por si acaso, eso no, ok. Si no tienen eso, le agregan más tomate y le ponen lo que ustedes tengan y un poquito de pasta de tomate, pasta, ok, no salsa. Listo,
and I put it on the side. I'm gonna continue with the peppers. I push it down, and then it's easy to take it out. Rinse. Now, all these vegetables, todos estos vegetales ya estaban lavados anteriormente. I already washed them before. So right now, sorry, I'm gonna start. Like if you want, you can use more than one pepper. Si quieren, pueden utilizar más de un pimiento, que es opcional, si ustedes quieren. Y los hacen picaditos como tipo cuadraditos. Primero los estoy cortando tipo juliana o julián. And then after, I just try to cut them as small as I can. And also square. It's easier that way. Because if you cut it like this, it's going to be thicker. Now, we're going to put this in the pan and I'm gonna show you, okay? Okay, so here's the pan. And I have the onions, as you can see. I'm gonna use this wok. Okay guys, so I'm cooking in this wok because I wanna have enough space to actually put the meatballs there when it's time. And right now, what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna turn this on. Actually, it was on already. And I'm gonna add the tomatoes and the pepper, okay? To this. Now, the same thing that I put for the meat, the garlic mix that I have, I already put some here, but if I wanna add something else, I can add more if I wanted to. If not, I can even use a little bit of the seasoning that we have. We have it here just in case, you know, we have this, we like it. I'm gonna put a little bit of achiote, just to give a little color. Achiote is a seed that people can buy it and mix it with oil, and you have to heat it up so the color comes out, but you can also buy it already in the bottle, so that's okay. So I'm gonna add a little bit of pepper too, okay? And here, good. And I'm gonna add a little bit of Maggi. A little bit of Maggi gives a good flavor. It's a mix of different things, like different spices, so I'm gonna put a little bit of Maggi. Okay, if you want, you can add a little bit more, but remember the meatballs are already seasoned too, and this one is just for the sauce. Okay, so right now, as you can see, I'm mixing this up. Look guys, let me show you. Okay, so this is all mixed now. So this is going to start cooking. I have the water over here. Oh, and check it out guys. This is one of the pots that I clean, and I have a video of that. So make sure that you check that one. Look how nice and clean it looks, okay? So right now we have that. And this is the other one that I also clean. Look at how it looks, super cool. Okay, so let's continue. So don't forget to check that video. Now we're going to open the fridge, and I need to have tomato paste, and hold on 1 second, the other one here that I have is tomato sauce, okay? And this is going to help me thicken it up, please. Okay, so I'm gonna add this right now, and it's gonna give that red color too. So I'm gonna add 2 spoons. Good. 2 spoons of tomato paste. And I'm gonna add what I have of this tomato sauce. It's the one that you use for pizzas or for the spaghetti, it's okay. So this one, I'm gonna add all of what we have here. I have another one on my little pantry if I need it. I'm gonna add some water here. Add a little bit more water. Okay. Now I'm gonna leave this so it can start boiling. Okay. As you can see, here we have this mix. y vamos a dejar que se siga cocinando. Aquí mezclé la cebolla, el tomate, el pimiento. Le puse un poquito de pasta de tomate, pasta, chicos. Y también le puse la salsa que es para pizzas o para espaguetis, que la venden en cualquier supermercado, ¿ok? Del puré de tomate o pasta de tomate, le puse dos cucharadas, porque vamos a hacer que esto se esté. Lo vamos a dejar a medium temperature, ok, y vamos a dejar que esto empiece a hervir. While this is cooking, I'm gonna start making the meatballs, ok, and I'm gonna show you that too. Ok, guys, so let me see, let me put this over here, and the meatballs, I'm gonna be here. Some people like to cook the meatballs separately, but when I buy the meat that is for the meatballs and everything, I buy the one that doesn't have fat and stuff. So it's okay if you cook it right here with the sauce and everything. Now, if you want, you can cook it separately. If not, you can cook it in the same way that I'm doing right now. It's optional. You know, this is how I do it. And hopefully, if you like it, it's cool. You can try to make it, okay? So let me show you how I'm gonna make my little meatballs, and I'm gonna continue showing you. Okay, guys, so right now, let me rinse what I have here, what I use to chop everything. This dish is really simple, it's really, really easy. You don't need that many ingredients. Es fácil de hacer, no necesitas tantos ingredientes. Y es super fácil. I'm gonna show you. Right now, I'm gonna put this in medium. From medium to low, okay. As you can see, it starts to boil, okay. Y no quiero que se queme, por eso lo bajé ahorita a la temperatura, a lo más bajito que está, para que se vaya cocinando la cebolla, el tomate, el pimiento y todo esto vaya cogiendo sabor. ¿Sí ven? Parece poquito, pero este sartén es bastante grande. So. Y el agua también ya a punto de hervir, todavía no. Y lo que les quería enseñar, chicos, tengo aquí mis seguidores, mi compañerito Samson. ¿Qué papi? ¿Cuál es tu papito? Dice, mamá, yo no sé, pero estás cocinando algo rico porque ya huele muy delicioso. ¿Cierto, papi? Este es mi bebé, este es mi Samson, y aquí está mi Chuli, mi Lala. Y ellos siempre están viendo a mamá qué hace, ¿verdad? Dice, sí, mamá. Siempre están aquí. Ok, chicos, entonces vamos a continuar. Y les voy a enseñar ahora cómo vamos a hacer las albóndigas, ¿ok? Ok, déjenme lavar las manos. Let me wash my hands again. Because I touch my chunky. And I'm cooking my nails. So, I'm going to get a plate. And we're going to start making the meatballs, ¿ok? I'm going to have like a specific size of something. You can use a spoon to actually have this. Now, I already put onion, garlic, pepper, and a little bit of salt here, okay? And this one, I marinated just a little while ago. So right now, we're gonna start making the little balls, okay? Now, I'm gonna use this measurement, and what you're gonna do is that you're going to make the balls like this. And you put it here. If you want, you can make it a little bit bigger, that's okay. Also put one egg here, okay, guys? Entonces, aquí mezclé cebolla, pimienta, un huevo, ajo. Entonces vamos a hacer las bolitas. No sé cuántas me vayan a salir, yo creo que me van a salir bastantes. Voy a hacer unas bolitas de tamaño mediano. Okay. Y así es como las vamos a ir preparando. Okay. Si no quieres utilizar la cuchara, no la utilices, no importa. Si quieres la utilizas, si no, no. Y ya sabes la medida, la haces al ojo. Pero si quieres tener una medida, puedes utilizar la cuchara y listo. You can use the spoon if you want to have, you know, almost the same size. Otherwise, you don't have to. Use the spoon, just grab it with your hands, and then that's it. Just make the little bowl. I'm gonna make it like this size because it's nice. It's a good portion. And obviously, I'm gonna give Sean a few of these ones, okay? The meatballs inside the sauce because I want the flavor of the meat to be mixed with the sauce. Si las cocinas, porque estoy cocinando las albóndigas junto con la salsa, porque quiero que la salsa tenga el sabor de la carne. Porque si las cocinas aparte, en agua o al horno, es que ese saborcito no va a estar dentro de la salsa. Por lo menos a mí me gusta, no sé. Pero es opcional, si ustedes quieren la pueden hacer distinta. So that's why I decided to do like this. Because I wanna have the flavor of the noodles. Okay. So I'm gonna continue. So I have 16. Let's see how many I have. I think I'm probably gonna end up having like 20 or 25, maybe, I'm not sure. But I'm gonna show you. And what I put here for onions, it was really like a quarter of onion, of pear onion or white onion. Okay. Because if you put a lot, then it's gonna be too oniony. You have enough onions in the sauce, so. When I cook enough for today and the next day, so. Try to make last at least an extra meal or two, depending. That's why I want to have enough meatballs. Once we finish with this one, we're going to put this in the sauce so I can continue to cook with the sauce, okay, guys? Okay, so now we're going to put these ones in the sauce, okay guys? Let me turn on the camera so I can show you. I'm gonna wash my hands right now so I can touch everything else. Hold on, Always wash your hands, guys. And I'm gonna put this over here. I'm gonna wash it in a little bit. Let me put the meatballs inside, okay guys? Okay, so right now I'm gonna start putting the meatballs inside the sauce. Let me turn this. Let me mix it. Working nicely. Okay, see? And we're gonna start with this one. Okay. Try to put them around so they don't get stuck to each other. I ended up with these two little ones. Very, very little balls. Okay? So here we have, and I'm gonna add a little bit of water here, okay? So we have enough water to cover the meat. Maybe like a half a cup. No, maybe a cup. Okay, just a little bit. That's it. And right now, I'm not going to mix it, I'm just try to place the last one, wasn't like in. But if you move it, the meat is going to move and it's going to actually become just brown beef. So try not to touch it. Right now I'm just fixing the ones that were in the pot, okay? And that's it. And then, okay, y vamos a dejar que esto se cocine en fuego bajo, okay? El agua de los fideos. Ya estoy viendo, vamos a poner ahí. Chicos, no muevan las albóndigas. Si ustedes mueven las albóndigas, se van a desarmar y esto ya no va a ser espagueti en vivo, sino va a ser solamente sweet o just pasta mixed with meat. So, déjenlas ahí que empiece a cocinarse con todo lo que está ahí. Le voy a agregar un poquito de esa zona todo que tenemos extra, solamente para que se complemente un poquito más. Un poquito, just a little bit. I'm gonna add a little bit of this mix of different herbs that I have. And do not stir or touch it, okay? Because if you do, the meatballs, they are not gonna be meatballs anymore. Okay guys, so right now, what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna put the noodles in the water, because as you can see, the water is already boiling. So I'm gonna put the noodles there. And I already washed my hands. And I already washed everything that I used before, where I was touching the meat and everything else. So make sure that you clean the area that you're working, okay? Voy a poner la pasta en este momento, chicos. asegúrense de lavarse las manos, asegúrense de lavar todo lo que utilizaron donde estaban tocando la carne para que todo esté súper limpio y no vaya a haber algún tipo de contaminación en sus productos, ¿ok? En su comida. Entonces vamos a poner una cara por el aire. Okay. And I'm gonna put the other part right here too. Okay. Voy a dejar que se cocine. I'm gonna add a little bit of water. Right now I just put the noodles. And I'm gonna add a little water just to make sure I have enough. Good. Now right now the meatballs, they've been boiling for a little bit, so what happened is that I'm gonna try to move them so the other side start to cook too. Make sure that you don't move it too fast. I don't want your meatballs to get all a mess, you know, so make sure that you turn them nicely. As you can see, they still look like a meatball. And right now, we're going to leave this boiling. Okay, just leave it there. The noodles. When these noodles are gonna be done, I'm gonna put the other package to set, okay? I didn't wanna use another big pot because I need to have enough time to cook this and everything, so I'm gonna show you when the pasta is going out and I'm gonna rinse it. Noodles are cooking right now and I'm gonna put the other noodles after these ones are done so they don't get all like tight and everything. The meatballs are right now cooking and boiling, as you can see. Okay, so I'm gonna leave it right now. I'm gonna leave it in medium so it doesn't get burnt or anything in the bottom. Because remember, we have tomato paste, and sometimes that can get a little sticky, okay? So I'm gonna continue showing you in a little bit, okay? So while this is cooking, as you can hear, I have a music, a background music, and that's my choncito. The whole family is here. As you can see, Papito's over there. Chuli is drinking some water, and Choncito's over there. But it's still there, you can see it, okay? But he's putting some music, so we can hear that in the background. I'm gonna continue showing you, okay? Actually, the chunkies wanna say hello again. Yay!
Hey, your meatballs
are spotting. Yay, chunky! Okay, so I'm gonna show you a little bit more, okay, guys? Everything is boiling, everything is cooking. You can hear the music. So I'm showing you the video. Okay, guys? Okay, guys, so right now I'm gonna take the noodles out. And noodles are ready to cook. And hold on, let me open this up. I'm gonna cook the other noodles here, okay? I'm gonna take them out. After, I'm gonna mix the noodles with the sauce and the meatballs so the noodles can take all the nice flavor. And right now, I'm taking it like this because I wanna save the water because so I don't have to wait too long for the other pasta to boil, okay? I'm gonna use some filter water to rinse the noodles. I love this container, me encanta. Super chévere, se puede cubrir todo. Y ahorita vamos a poner el agua filtrada para enjuagarlo. Para quitarle un poquito del sal. So right now we're going to leave this one. Okay, I'm going to leave it here until the other noodles are splash this. Always wash your dishes with juice. Siempre laven lo que van utilizando para que no se les acumule tanto plato y tanta cosa. So you don't have a lot of stuff to wash after. And you keep everything clear and clean. I don't know. I like to do that. Okay, so right now, the meatballs is still boiling, cooking. And right now I put the water for the other package of pasta that I'm gonna cook, because I'm cooking for, so we have enough for today and tomorrow. Okay, so I'm gonna wait until this starts to boil again. It's not gonna take that long because I saved some of the water and I added up just a little bit. And I don't have to add any more salt or because I already put oil and salt here, so I don't have to do that. I don't know, I think it's practical. If you want, you can throw everything and then it's start boiling again. Or you can use a bigger pot, that's okay. I just decided to use this one today, and that's okay. Now here, I'm gonna stir this. Make sure to use, you know, a spoon or spatula or something that is with a little, you know, scratch your pot, depends. So as you can see here, the meatballs are cooking nicely. They are in the shape of a meatball, okay? And here, as you can see, I started picking it up. Okay, remember, this is going to be mixed with the noodles. Okay, so right now, I'm gonna put this over here. I'm gonna put the fire in the lowest temperature. I'm gonna, this one, I'm gonna put in high temperature so it can start boiling, and I'm gonna show you how everything continues, okay? Now, this is a good red color. If you want a more red, then just add it up a little bit more tomato paste. If no, it's fine. Okay, so ahorita les estoy enseñando cómo ya está cocinándose las albóndigas. Como que ustedes pudieron observar, las albóndigas se están manteniendo con su forma de albóndiga. Y ahorita ya se están cocinando. Vamos a dejarlo en temperatura baja para que esto se vaya cocinando poco a poco. Si tienen una tapa, lo pueden tapar. Si no, simplemente aquí el agua para los fideos, para el otro paquete que voy a hacer. Porque estoy preparando suficiente comida para hoy y mañana para poder hacer esto. Luego que estén ya los fideos cocinados, los voy a dejar en un costado para después mezclarlos con salsa de los meatballs. Si ustedes quieren que sea la salsa más roja, pueden agregar un poquito más de tomato paste. Si no, lo pueden dejar así nada más y ya está, porque está suficiente de rojito. Pero ya es decisión de ustedes. A mí me gusta que esté así. Si veo que le necesito un poquito más, le pondré, pero no quiero tampoco que esté muy, muy ácido. Si tú le pones demasiada pasta, se hace demasiado ácido. Entonces, para mi gusto. Y lo que voy a agregar un poquito, ya al finalizar, le voy a poner un poquito de albahaca, basil. I'm gonna put a little bit of basil at the end. If you want, you can put oregano. I don't like oregano that much, but if you like it, you can put oregano. But I decided to put a little bit of basil because it gives a nice flavor and everything. And that's good. So I'm gonna show you in a little bit how everything is continuing cooking. So see you in a little bit. So right now we're going to put two cookies, the other package, okay. Vamos a poner a cocinar el otro paquete y lo vamos a separar en half. Okay. Okay, everything here is boiling, looking nice. See how it's keeping it up? You see how the color is getting red and red? Because as it cooks and as it boils down, everything is going to be nice. And the meatballs, see, they look like meatballs. Okay, so I'm gonna keep showing you how everything is gonna continue cooking. Okay, right now I'm gonna leave the noodles, the other package of noodles, here. And I'm gonna leave this cooking nice and slow. I'm gonna mix this. Okay, so right now, and that's it. For So we just want to take a little bit of the excess of the water out. Okay, we're going to check the meatballs. They're looking good. Hold on, let me show you guys. Okay, as you can see here, we have the meatballs. Look, it's thickened now. You see how nice it is? Good. It's thick. And remember, we're going to mix the noodles here. So obviously, you need to have a little bit of juice so they can soak in. Okay, so right now, I'm going to taste a little bit and see if I need a little bit of salt or something. No? Good. Need just a little bit of salt. I'm gonna put just a little bit. And I'm gonna add the basil right now. Okay? Hold on 1 second, guys. I'm gonna put a little bit of basil. Just a little bit. Like a pinch. We like basil. So I'm gonna put a little bit of basil. And that's it. All set. Okay. Now we're going to mix this. Mm, it smells good. It smells really, really good. Now to make sure that you have everything cooked, asegurarse que ya todo está bien cocinadito, ustedes pueden probar un poquito. De otra cuchara, por favor. ¿Ven cómo está la gordita? Muy bien. Ha tenido cocinándose esto casi una hora porque obviamente lo dejé cocinar suave, despacio, para que no se deshagan, ¿ok? Voy a cortar una gordita para ver si esté todo bien cocinadito por dentro. Ok. Como ustedes pueden ver, I just opened this one. So everything inside is nice and cooked. ¿Sí? Thinking there. Good. And fine. I'm going to take this one. Mmm, it's good. Very good. Okay, so I already put a little bit of salt here. I think it's good. I'm gonna ask Josito if he wanna call it taste or not. But I'm gonna show you when everything is all mixed, okay? Give
Josito
a little taste and
yes. I love it.
It's good.
It's so good.
So what are we going to do right now, guys, is that we're going to put the noodles there.
I'm gonna
turn off because the meat, everything is already done, so I'm gonna put the noodles here to start to mix with the sauce. Okay. I didn't put any butter, no le puse ninguna mantequilla ni nada a los fideos, ¿por qué? Porque la carne molida por lo general tiene un poquitito de grasa. So, mix this. Tengo un show, guys. ¿Sí? Good. Into my meatballs. Yay! I'm getting meatballs, guys. And you're going to eat this with Parmesan cheese. Okay. Okay. Estoy mezclando con mis albóndigas y como ustedes pueden ver, las albóndigas están redonditas, están bien, no se dañaron. Voy a mezclar los otros fideos y les voy a enseñar cómo queda. Okay, guys. Here is my spaghetti and meatballs. As you can see, it's done. Looks really good. Tastes really good because Josito already tastes. I'm gonna show you how it's gonna look. You can put a little bit of Parmesan cheese on the top, and then that's it. It's delicious. If you have some garlic bread or something like that, ooh, you can actually have that. If not, just like that, it's okay. Okay. So thank you for watching. I hope you like it. Like I told you before, this is Gracie's way. So if you're making it a different way, cool. If not, if you wanna try to make it how I did it, it's really good too. So, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, comment, share, and follow. Okay? See you guys. And I'm gonna show you how the plate looks in a little bit. Okay? See you. Love you. Josito say love you too. You can hear that. So, thank you for watching, guys. Mmm. It's delicious. And it tastes really, really, really good. Okay, chicos. So, gracias por ver. Así es como quedaron las albóndigas con el espagueti. se ven deliciosas, están ricas, las albóndigas se ven totalmente formaditas. Y les voy a enseñar ya cómo queda en el plato. Pueden comerlo con queso parmesano. Si tienen también pancito, le pueden poner un poquito de mantequilla con ajo o algo así, y se la pueden comer de esa manera. Y si no, así nada más. Gracias por ver el video. Suscríbanse, comenten y síganme. Bye, see you guys.